Hello again, everybody. I'm Brian Rice, and you're locked in to This Week in Tennessee Softball. On this week's show, I sit down once again with Tennessee co-head coach Karen Weekly. Julia will sit down with Tennessee infielder and pitcher Cheyanne Tarango, and we'll have the introduction of our rapid-fire segment. We'll also take a look at the week ahead. And as promised, we're now joined by Tennessee co-head coach Karen Weekly. Coach, thanks for joining us. It was a good, successful first weekend out for the Lady Vols. Just tell us a little bit about the trip to Utah.
It was a good trip. The kids traveled well. They were warriors the whole time, despite any conditions that were thrown their way. We had a beautiful first day in St. George, and then the temperatures got a little bit colder every day that we went along, and by Saturday it was pretty frigid playing out there. But they didn't complain, and they just kept battling, and we came away with 5 wins, which is key.
You had a lot of things happen out in Utah. No-hitter, an 18-run game. Raven had a career high, which at this point in her career is something significant. Hannah Akamine sort of busted out. What impressed you most about your team this first week?
Wow, there were a lot of things that were impressive. It was nice to see Raven at full strength and putting that swing on the ball to hit a grand slam and get that power stroke back. Both Raven and Kat Dotson had grand slams for us, so to have that ability in those slapper roles to hit the ball over the fence is going to be big. Hannah Akamine, we talked about before, and it was nice to really see that come to fruition with Hannah going out that first weekend, leading us behind the plate, and being a leader at the plate. Hannah did a great job on her home run. We were facing a tough pitcher who was throwing us a lot of off-speed pitches. We talked about the adjustment we needed to make against that pitcher, and Hannah went up there and executed it perfectly and hit a ball over the fence. And, you know, things like that are great momentum changers in games, and it was at a key time, and I was just really proud of the way she played.
Last week we talked about Cheyanne Tarango and what you're going to get from her in the field, at the plate, and in the circle, and she really impressed this weekend, didn't she?
She really did. Her first outing, she started off a little bit slow, came in a relief role, but turned it around the next inning, and from that point on pitched extremely well. And the next day she got a start and just did a fantastic job, and it's really nice to know that we have somebody that solid behind the Renfros, and then along with Aaron Gabriel too, who's only going to get better and better. Aaron's been slowed by injury, but she's going to be a real solid performer. But Shy was fantastic and anchoring the middle of our lineup. That's something we've been looking for as coaches. Somebody in that 5, 6, 7 slot right there that you can really, really count on. And Shy hit in the 6th slot for us this weekend and just did a great job leading the team with home runs. Another one like Hannah, who had some home runs at critical times, you know, and there's those points where you get that one big hit that kind of blows things open, gives everybody else on the team a sense of confidence, and Shy came up big.
This weekend, it's off to Tampa, the USF tournament. You meet a bit of a familiar face this year with Ken Erickson, who you coached with this summer with Team USA, and Lauren Gibson played for all summer on Team USA. Talk about facing off that tournament and the familiar face down in Tampa.
Well, that'll be fun, and you know, Ken's a guy that Ralph and I have known for years. He and Ralph go way back with Team USA. They've got a lot more familiarity probably than even I do or Lauren, but that'll be fun for all of us, and nice to see a familiar face, and you always enjoy playing people who you know just go out there and respect the game and are good sports and play the game the way it's supposed to be played. And we hear that USF has a beautiful new stadium. It'll be nice to be on a campus where you're, you know what you're going to get in terms of the field and everything that's going to go along with that. So we're looking forward to a great tournament down in Tampa.
Coach, good luck in Tampa. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you here next week.
Thank you, Brian.
Now Julia catches up with Cheyanne Tarango, and we introduce the new Rapid Fire segment.
Thanks, Brian. I'm here with infielder and pitcher Cheyanne Tarango. Cheyanne, thanks for joining us today. So you hit 636 this past weekend with 2 home runs and 6 RBIs. You also picked up your first pitching career victory. As a pitcher who also hits, what's more exciting?
Actually, I like them both equally because pitching-wise, you know, I have to go out there and it's like the center of attention, basically. And when you're hitting, it's the same thing. You're also the center of attention, and you're just kind of battling back and forth with the pitcher. And so it's nice to be on both sides.
When you're doing both, how do you stay focused? And make sure that you're performing well at on both ends?
It's more like in between innings, because you have that time to warm up, and when you go in the dugout for before you hit, you kind of have a time to relax and talk to the other teammates about the pitcher, so it's good the in-between innings.
Is there anything in particular that you guys as a team are working on for this upcoming tournament?
No, just kind of staying focused and continue to drive the ball as much as we can and, you know, keep our numbers down as pitchers.
All right. We're going to switch things up a little bit right now. We're going to do a rapid fire round. I'm going to ask you some questions and you're going to answer them as quickly as you can. Who's the funniest person on the team?
Tori Lewis.
Who's the best dancer?
Whitney.
What's your favorite food?
Mexican.
What's your major?
Speech pathology.
What's harder, pitching or hitting?
Hitting.
What's your favorite color?
Blue.
What's your favorite game day accessory?
Bow.
What's your favorite road trip with UT?
Vegas.
If you can meet one person, who would it be?
Probably my great-grandfather.
All right, you survived the rapid fire round. Good job, Cheyenne.
Thanks.
All right, now let's take a look at this week's upcoming game schedule.
The Lady Vols will take on North Carolina State, Coastal Carolina, and a 12th-ranked USF this week. It will be the first time that Tennessee will play a ranked team this season.
Thanks for joining us for another edition of This Week in Tennessee Softball.
Be sure to tune into the free audio at utsports.com of this weekend's games and join us again next week.